Man, 1,200 houses a month. We'll get to that because I know that's probably got a lot of people's heads spinning. Like, how in the world is that possible? But right. You started out in real estate. Really, it was like every other agent. You're out there just hustling it. But the topic of today is how to grow a successful real estate team. So you went from the individual agent to a team leader. How did that happen? And, yeah. And why did that happen?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So, yeah, great question. So, I started my real estate career in 2014 as a single agent. My first year, I sold about $3.2 million in production as a single realtor, and wanted to leverage myself back then. And the only way for me to do that was to become the traditional team leader. So I created the Pat Hayes Group, hired two buyer's agents. I focused on the listings. Of course, you know, whoever wins, has the most signs in the yards, is going to win at listings. So I focused on listings and made the phone ring with a lot of sign calls. And our second year, my second year in real estate, which was my first year as a team leader, 2015, we did $12.5 million in production, 61 transactions here in San Antonio. So it's been a fun ride, and you know, it's always great to leverage yourself, and so that's the whole reason why I you know, became a team leader and created the Pat Hayes Group in 2015.
Awesome. Yeah, it's a pretty quick trajectory. Seems like you were following the path that most real estate agents that want to be really successful long term in this business, that's what they do. They start as a successful agent, learn the business, start networking, create a team, get top talent on the team, grow and develop them, and just keep crushing it. So you can start a team. Anyone can do that.
That's right.
I mean, you're going to be successful. You closed your team closed 12 million. Was that the team's first year or?
That was the first full year okay. for the Pat Hayes Group. Yep. First year we did 12.5 million in production, 61 transactions here in San Antonio, Texas.
You don't do that by accident. So how did that happen? Like, how did you go about choosing the right team members, the folks that you knew were going to be successful, they're going to be hard charging, and also it was also going to be that good working relationship, because you don't want to work with everyone. You want to work right. with folks that are going to work well with you, and it's also going to grow them and develop them over time.
That's right. Yeah. You know, I was looking for, hungry agents. You know, I was looking for agents that were just starting out as well, too. You know, they didn't have any bad habits, and I could kind of groom them and teach them and guide them and coach them, for what I wanted. And so, hired two fairly new, successful realtors, and, they were hungry. And so they didn't really have a lot of money to spend on lead generation. Right. And so that was that was my responsibility, is to generate, quality, buyer and seller leads. And so that's what I did. We crushed it our first year. Yeah. 12.5 million, 61 transactions are our first year. And then, then actually that's whenever I found EXP Realties at the end of my second year in 2015 in December.
Yeah. So EXP Realty aside, that your plan was to grow that production team. Like, how many agents did you have at the end of the first year?
So I had three.
Okay, three. So yeah. What was your, like, if you were to go back to that moment, what would your 10-year projection have been? Like, how large of the team? Like, what were you trying to do? Or were you just trying to hit a certain level and just kind of coast? Or
yeah, I was really wanting to grow a big team. And I was, I had a goal of about, eventually, 10 or 15 buyer's agents, hopefully doing, $100 million a year in production. After my second year, that's whenever I found EXP Realty, and I started growing another team, a revenue share organization that, just like you said, yeah, we closed over 1,200 houses just alone last year, 4,100 agents spanning 47 states, five Canadian provinces, and 10 countries.
So what are the difference in those? Because there are a lot. If you would have grown a huge mega team, and there are plenty of folks that do that, and it works great. But if you were to grown that 100 plus million, ton of transactions, versus you end up going the revenue share route, which is what EXP offers, growing a team. Like, what are the differences between a production team, Pat Hayes Group,
and a
revenue share team, which you have?
You know, and honestly, as a team leader, there comes a lot of responsibility, a lot of babysitting, as I call it. You're the one that's actually out there spending all the money, generating all the leads. The agents don't really have a vested interest you know, in the leads, because I'm the team leader. I'm the one that's responsible for spending money on the leads. And so, you know, I found it kind of difficult really trying to scale and grow a real estate production team just because of a lot of the headaches in the background. You know, a lot of the babysitting, you know, a lot of the, you know, the agents, you know, obviously they're not W-2 employees, you know, they're 1099 employees. And so they don't have a base salary with, you know, commissions and bonuses. That's not the structure that I had. And so they're really just, you know, kind of working, you know, as they please. And so it got a little frustrating, you know, whenever I was the one that had the big goals and spending all the money on generating all the leads. And, you know, some of these agents just didn't really take it so serious. You know, not as serious as I was. And so I was really trying to, you know, scale that. I had met some other team leaders that had already done that. And I was kind of following, you know, their pace as well. You know, they had hit, you know, over $100 million a year in production, you know, their fourth or fifth or sixth year as a team leader. But, you know, they did say, hey, it wasn't easy. There was a lot of headaches, a lot of babysitting, you know, a lot of agents that they had to get rid of. You know, they fired a lot of agents and they hired a lot of agents and, you know, they did the disc profile to figure out the, you know, the best hire and who they wanted as their team leader or who they wanted as their, you know, their head buyer's agent or their head listing agent. So there's a lot of different ways to scale a team. But, you know, I found it very difficult back in 2015, 2016 to really scale a large real estate production team.
Yeah, it's not easy. Otherwise, everyone would do it. And the folks that do, I mean, they're rewarded very well. But you're a serial entrepreneur.
Yep.
Entrepreneurs, business owners look for leverage. That's where investments come in and starting businesses. You found a very unique one with eXp through the revenue share plan to build a team that's different from the production team, but instead build a team that grows back exponentially without your work, almost like rental properties, but even better.
Right.
So we got maybe 60 seconds left. Can kind of explain how that has worked for you and the benefits that you've seen over the past few years with the revenue share team.
Absolutely. Yeah. It's been a game changer ever since. Ever since I saw eXp in December of 2015, I saw that they had a beautiful revenue share model where you can attract agents to the eXp model and get compensated very handsomely for it, for helping grow a organization that you're a shareholder of, right? And so we're a publicly traded company, and I saw the opportunity that eXp had to offer, and I ran with it. So, you know, fast forward, I've been able to personally sponsor 50 agents to the organization, and out of those 50 agents, it's grown into 4,118 agents as of just a little bit ago, spanning the 47 states, 5 Canadian provinces, and 10 countries. You know, paying me six figures a month in revenue share. And, you know, my my whole organization closed over 1,200 houses just alone last month. And so it's a fun, different way to scale a massive team. And, you know, I'm not responsible for, you know, the agents. I'm not responsible for generating the leads. You know, I still have my small production team here in San Antonio, the Pat Hayes Group. But I love growing a revenue share organization, or I love growing in a company that I'm a shareholder of. And my organization is actually growing by about over 230 agents are joining my revenue share organization every single month. So that is leverage right there. I can't go do that anywhere else other than eXp. So it's been a lot of fun.
I love it. And I'm also blessed to be a part of that.
Yes.
So you have your core production team and you're able to now have that at a level that's fun and enjoyable for you. It's not stressful and hard work. I mean,
right.
Things happen, but for the most part, you're selling houses when and how you want to.
That's
and you're just pouring into thousands and thousands of agents to help them grow their business and ultimately achieve the success that you have with your revenue share team. So
that's right.
It's amazing.